Keep us in mind, always give strength to your people, for we can be with you even one day to better than a thousand blessings. In the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
And also.
What we call here today is nice to see the rain again. You're on the same. First, let us confess our sins and penitence of the day. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against each other, in thoughts and word and deed. Remember that you serve us, our only Lord and Father. We are to the Son, and we pray for all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, and the life of us. For we are the Son of the Spirit, and we are the ministry of the news of our life. To the glory of the Lord. Almighty God, forgive us through the thanks. Have mercy upon us. Pardon us of all our sins. Confirm our faith in all things. And keep the united prayer to Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. God and Father, we will love you in all things and above all things, and we should joy you have prepared for us beyond all our imagination. That the Lord Jesus Christ, from this spirit in the Holy Spirit, and God ever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord was addressed to me as follows. Son of man, prophesy against the shepherds of Israel. Prophesy and say to them, shepherds, the Lord says this, trouble for the shepherds of Israel who feed themselves. Shepherds ought to feed their flock. Yet you have fed on milk, you have dressed yourselves in wool, you have sacrificed the fatted sheep, but failed to feed the flock. You failed to make weak sheep strong and care for the sick ones, or bandage the wounded ones. You failed to bring back strays, or look for the lost. On the contrary, you've ruled them cruelly and violently. For lack of a shepherd, they have scattered. They become the prey of any wild animal. They have scattered far. My flock is straying this way and that, from mountain to mountain. My flock has been scattered all over the country. No one bothers about them, and no one looks for them. Well then, shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. As I live, I swear it, it is the Lord who speaks. Since my flock has been looted, and for lack of a shepherd is now the prey of any wild animal. Since shepherds have stopped bothering about my flock, since my shepherds feed themselves rather than my flock, in view of all this, shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. The Lord says this, I'm going to call the shepherds to account. I'm going to take my flock back from them, and I shall not allow them to feed my flock. In this way, the shepherds will stop feeding themselves. I will rescue my sheep from their mouths. They will not prey on them anymore. For the Lord says this, I'm going to look after my flock myself and keep order in view. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, Lord God.
Response to the psalm, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd.
There is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me along the right path, he is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness,
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let your face shine on your servant and keep you with the dream. Hallelujah. The Lord is with you.
And your Lord is with
you. A reading from the Gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, the Lord.
Jesus said to the disciples, the kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who took out a labor to hire workers to his vineyard. He made an agreement with the workers for 1 denarius a day and sent them to his vineyard. Going out about the third hour, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace and said to them, you go to my vineyard too and I will give you a fair wage for the vineyard. At about the 6th hour and then at about the 9th hour, they went out into the same. Then at about the 11th hour, he went out and found more men standing by him and said to them, why have you been standing here idle all day? For no one has hired us, he answered. He said to them, you go to my vineyard too. In the evening, the owner of the vineyard said to the village, call the workers and pay their wages, starting from the last arrival, beginning with the first. So those who were hired at the 11th hour came forward and received 1 denarius each. In the first day, they expected to get more, but the two received 1 denarius each. They took it and grumbled at the landowner. The men who came to ask him said to them, we need only 1 hour, and we have treated them the same as us, for we have done a heavy day's work in all the week. He answered, one of them said, my friend, I have not been unjust to you. Did we not agree on 1 denarius? If you earn them to go, I choose to pay the last coming as much as I pay you, but I know I can do what I like on my own. Why then should I enjoy you? Thus the last will be first, and the first last. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Let us pray for the church and for the world, and thank God for all of you. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we promise you to find Jesus Christ and get him in the same place. We give thanks, Father, for all that you've been with us from the beginning to now, for your greatest work by which the heavens and the earth are made. For we can ever be in your own image, give us a clear and answer to the call. The written word has been bound to your feet and so shined upon our way. For the mystery of the word made flesh and the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, and for the preservation of the true and living word in itself. Lord, have mercy. Father, we pray for all young people this time. We have had our A-level results and are waiting for our GCSE results. Be with them in this difficult time as we prepare for what is best for them. May they be strong in spirit to serve their generation and to follow your will. Lord, have mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Father, pray for those who are sick in various forms, especially those who are suffering from the coronavirus. Give them strength to survive the next day, so that you are with them at all times to comfort them and keep your faith strong. We pray for all who care for the sick, especially family and friends. Give them strength, go from day to day. We also pray for all medical staff who are struggling to contain the virus, and all who serve as the ones who find the cure. Lord, have mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Father, give to the rulers of this land and to all the leaders of the nation the vision to move beyond racial ambition and national violence. As obedient to your law, and with concern for the needs of others, they may bring their gifts and treasures which will come in service of the kingdom, and so promote the unity of people to the glory of your name. Lord, in your mercy. Father, we rejoice in your promise that as our day is, so shall our strength be. And we ask your help for all those who are old and weary with the burden of life. In your strength, may they find joy and peace. And in advance of you, in the realm of your love. Lord, in your mercy. God of nations, your kingdom goes over all. Have mercy on us, open the way of God. Send your joy and peace in the hearts of men and women, and bind them in the spirit of the war. So all nations and people may learn to live as members of one family and obedient to your laws. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly Father, make you in the prayer of all who love and love and suffer, no matter what them is so much bigger than ours, and your will for them is always for the good. And the monthly Give us the eye and hope in the trouble and move into our good salvation. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear
us, remember those who died in faith of Christ, especially those who are and so more. And those who are down the grass of the terrorist family. Father, pray for peace. Alice, pray for peace. Pray for peace. Send your guidance. Martin Martin. Chris Jones. Ruby Humphries. Angela Martin. Sydney Everton. And Bill Gibbs. Rejoice in the fellowship of the Lord's holy saints. We commend yourselves to all Christian people of fear and love. Bless your Father. Accept this prayer. The Spirit of your Son. Our Savior. Please stand to peace. Christ and the peace, you reconcile to God in one body of the cross. Immediately we share the peace. The peace of the Lord God is with you.
And with us.
Let us share a sign of peace in each other. Blessing you, Lord, for all creatures and creatures for this bread of God, for that will be in the hands of me. Become for us a bread of life.
Blessing you, Lord, forever.
Blessing you, Lord, for all creatures and creatures for this wine of God, to the divine and holy in your hand, and become our spiritual food.
Blessing you, Lord, forever.
Lord, accept our sacrifice as a holy change of gifts. By offering up your goodness, may we receive the gift to each other. Trust in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And the Lord be
with you. Lift up your heart.
Amen.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, we give you thanks and praise to the beloved Son, Jesus Christ, the living Lord, through whom we have through the whole thing. We will set by your victory this year, Jesus. By the power of the Holy Spirit, we do pledge. How your Son, born the blessed Virgin, to live on earth and live a better life. You have provided your darkness on the cross. You keep your name to death by dying for us, and reveal the resurrection by rising in new life, to fulfill your will and work with your holy people. Therefore, the angels and archangels, and all come in heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, gifts of bread and wine, feeding us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who the same night we prayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way after supper, he took the cup and gave him thanks. He took it and he gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the covenant, shed for you for many, the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, and remember it of me." Great is the mystery of faith. Christ is God. Christ is risen. Christ is risen. And so, Father, call the mighty death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice is once for the sins of the whole world. Rejoice in the mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and look at his coming glory. We celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you the sacrifice of faith and thanksgiving, we bring before this bread and this cup, and we thank you for making us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Then the Holy Spirit and the people, and God the one and kingdom, all who share this one bread and one cup, so we become the God and all the saints, may faith and glorify you forever to Jesus Christ our Lord. By him, with him, and in him, in the union of the Holy Spirit, for honor and glory be you, the mighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
As our Savior taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done upon earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We break this bread to share the body of Christ.
Glory to God, we are one body, because of all share in one bread.
Love of God,
we take our relations to God, come back to God.
Love of God,
we take our relations to God.
Love of God,
we thank you for your sins of the Lord.
This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who call to suffer.
Lord, I will never disgrace thee, but your sins of the world, my God.
The body of Christ. Amen.
The blood of Christ.
Amen.
Thank you.
With the Lord there is now spirit, fullness of redemption. Let us pray. God of mercy, by the sacrament you make upon the Christ, by becoming more like him on earth, may become to share his glory in heaven, with this and may be ever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May the peace of God be past all understanding. Keep your heart and mind in all the love of God and the Son Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessed God Almighty, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, among you and you, the Lord.
Amen.
Go in the